all right. Get some folks flowing in here. Hello, hello, everyone. As you come in, go ahead and drop in the chat box. Say hey real quick. Mr. Griff, you got some music for us as we enter in the
Do
chat.
I got some music? Hold on. I was just saying that I have been on my, today is Nelson Mandela's birthday, and it's also Mandela Day, right? So around the world, it's a day like being in the community, kind of like Martin Luther King, a day on instead of a day off. So I've been on my Afro beats. My South African, it's South African house music, but they call it I'm a Piano. I'm a piano music, so it's good. A little beat to come in on it. And I got some music for you too, since it's your birthday week. Birthday week.
Come on in this chat room. All right. As you guys are coming in, I just go ahead and welcome you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good afternoon. If this is your first time joining us, thank you for coming. And if you're coming back, if you're returning, it's good to see you again. Go ahead and let us know that you're here, you're in the room, okay? Really quick, my name is Mariah. I am the program manager here at the Madam Walker Legacy Center, and I am super excited to be one of your camp counselors this summer for the 2023 Madam Walker Summer Institute, okay? Now, before I jump in, I want to take a moment again to ask you to drop in the chat box. If this is your first time joining us, if you're coming back, what grade you're in, let us know who we have the pleasure of working with today. All right. While you guys are doing that, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about the Madam Walker Legacy Center. Okay.
Nice.
Sitting in a historic building located right here in Indianapolis, Indiana. All right. The building was created and named after Madam C.J. Walker, the first woman millionaire entrepreneur whose donations and efforts contributed to much of the growth of the Black community in Indianapolis. Yes, clap it up for that, because that is amazing. Okay. Our mission here at the Walker is to continue her legacy by inspiring, engaging, empowering individuals in our culturally diverse community. And that includes each of you who are here with us today. Okay. No matter where you are, welcome, welcome, welcome. And we hope you come back to rock out with us, to vibe with us, to learn with us. And without further ado, I'm going to pass it over to my amazing co-camp counselor to introduce himself. Mr. Griffiths, on you.
Hey. Hold on, hold on. It is Miss Mariah's birthday week, so we going hard all week. This is a song I got for you on your birthday week.
Nobody pray for me. It's been a day for me. Yeah, yeah. Hey, I remember syrup sandwiches and gram allowances, finessing on them with some counterfeits, but now I'm counting this. Parmesan with my accountant lips. In fact, I'm down in this. You say when they move it, just to play for the analyst. Girl, I can buy your Westie.
Miss Mariah.
To the PM, PM, to the AM.
Hey.
Eat up your per diem, you just gotta hate them for me. If I quit your BM, I still rock.
That's for you, Miss Mariah. How about that? It's your birthday week. Hey, kids. Why? Earlier, I just found out I could do some things on Miss Machine. So it's a couple things. I got a voice disguiser, right? So maybe if your mom called the house, you could talk to her
like this. Mom, hello. How are you? I'm not having the best day that I can, but I'll be okay.
When I tell you she gonna hang up and call back, and when she call back, you can say, I've been messing with a balloon all day.
And my voice won't go back to regular. I don't know what it is. And for somebody like me with a deep baritone voice to have a high voice, that is the best thing in the whole world. I ain't even gonna lie. It's something I always wanted to have. Voice,
then
I can't, so you know,
I get to do all stuff like that all day today. How about that? So, happy birthday! You getting all kind of happy birthdays, Miss Mariah. But listen, okay. I want to ask y'all right now, what color are you feeling right now, Miss Mariah? What color?
I'm feeling, I don't even know. I'm feeling sky blue right now.
A light sky blue. What color are you guys feeling out there? Saffron. Stop it. Isn't that like velvet? What is saffron? Is that a, what color is saffron, Ms. Mariah? That's above my 64 colors.
If I'm not mistaken, it might be a yellow.
Okay, some strawberry. Oh, it's a yellow. Okay, well, listen, get me together. Okay, you better.
I only know this because I was searching for paint colors one day. See, the things you like at Home Depot, you know?
I know, that's right. Saffron, I like that. Deep red, pink, and yellow. I'm telling you, I'm feeling a turquoise, a aqua blue. I'm very calm. Mr. Griff been gone from his house since June 28th. I just got home yesterday. I am so glad. I'm waiting for my dogs to get here. I hope they recognize me. I've been gone for so long. Oh, Poppy, Orchard, and my sister, Yellow. So you feeling Poppy and Orchard, and your sister's Yellow. I like that, me and Chloe. Okay, now here go my other question. I've been working on y'all all day. If you were a superhero, who would you be? Me? Green Lantern. Green Lantern is from the DC universe. He wears a ring. He can make anything appear. It's kind of cool. Green Lantern. Ms. Mariah, any superhero ever?
This is a tough one. I need some ideas, y'all. Drop it in the chat.
They saying Spider-Man Miles Morales, a girl version of Black Lightning. Come, you better. Wonder Woman. You. Yes, Super Griff. I want you to be Super Griff. There's a couple Wonder Womans out there. Wonder Woman is so cool. She's in a new Flash too. I don't know if you've seen it or not, but she did a nice little cameo in the new Flash. So we got some Wonder Womans. We got some Spider-Mans, Miles Morales. Now also like anybody who could go invisible, I like those people too. Because you could just be right there in the same room just listening. Just hearing what people talk about, you're just nice and invisible, and you can see and hear everything. With that, but while y'all still thinking of superheroes and different colors, just want you to know that this is about to be the best week ever. It's the beginning of our Madam Walker Legacy Center Summer Institute. It's Tuesday, man, first day, so you know we gotta go. First day, we go hard. We do different. We get you ready for your week and feel good to be here. I miss Genesis. What's happening to Genesis? So Genesis came on probably 3 years ago and sat with us. Then she came on my lunch and learn during COVID. And then Genesis became a whole star. She is a viral sensation. All she does every day is pray and read Bible verses and tell you her spin on stories. And a little kid whose mama loved the Lord, and she is having fun online. So I'm a fan of Genesis. Genesis, you are awesome. We get to say she came out of our Madam Walker Legacy Summer Institute program. So yeah, Genesis is awesome. Okay, so they want me to go over the rules. A girl version. You so welcome, my dear. Rule number one, y'all know this is not school where you forget everything on Monday after y'all tell me what rule number one is.
I know y'all know.
And I'm gonna just go like this, just in case. No. Yes, Star. Pay attention. Pay attention all the time. Okay. Rule number two. What's rule number two, Star? Yeah. That she already on it. Ask questions in the chat. That's right. Oh, I love y'all. Pay attention. Ask questions in the chat. Rule number three. And today, rule number three is super duper important because we got an artist in the camp. Rule number three. What is that? Yes, Star. Again. Nope. Mia said it. Come prepared. Don't be this person. Mama! Again. Bye, my. Pay attention. Ask questions in the chat. Come prepared. And the fourth one, very simple. Yep, that's right, Tyson. Be respectful, and we add it, and be positive as well. How about that? That's our four rules. Not really rules per se, but actually some things you could use in your life. Just pay attention, ask questions generally. No question is dumb. Chances are somebody else was going to ask the same question. Come prepared all the time. So this is my preparation for today. So we got an artist, right? I got my color pens. I got my color pencils. I got regular pens. Listen, you don't have to be like me. I got my chalk. I got liquid markers. I'm over prepared today. Okay, you see all this? I'm here for it. I want all the smoke. But if you don't have all those things that Mr. Griff bought, know what's always good? A good old-fashioned pen or a pencil. If you got a pencil, a number two pen, I don't actually have, well, yeah, I do. Raiders, who knew? Got a whole Raiders pencil, brand new, never touched. Look at that eraser, Ms. Mariah, and look at that sharpness. I think I will go back and forth between my pen and my pencil. So, Ms. Mariah, you want to tell them about our amazing guest? Star said, be prepared, Griff. I'm working on it. You want to tell them about our awesome guest, or you want, or should I bring him up in my
large robot voice? You want me to bring him on right now? I am about to take over the world. Only thing I need to do is get a number two pencil, whatever. Okay,
I'll stop. Go ahead. You good?
I love it. Of our amazing guest, which I will let you do that today, Mr. Griff. I'm just going to quickly tell you guys about the Summer Institute. For any of our parents who are here, who are on this call, I'm going to drop a survey in the chat. If you guys could take a few minutes to complete that, that would be amazing. Now, guys, we are talking about arts this week, but we are also talking about entrepreneurship and philanthropy, okay? Keep in mind, we are here every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock, okay? Now, if you do some homework and you showcase what you learn and you post it, we're giving some prizes at the end of the session. That means that will happen next week, okay? So we got some goodies for y'all. So take account of what you're learning. Make a video, hop on TikTok, Instagram, whatever it is, and tag us in it, okay? So we can make sure we honor those people next week, all right? We're going to drop that chat, drop the survey in the chat. And parents, if you can knock that out for us, that will be amazing. I'm going to pass it back over to you, Mr. Griff, to bring up our amazing featured artist today.
Let me tell you something. I could go on and tell you I would, but this is why I love Mr. Gary G. Mr. Gary G does this, okay? Mr. Gary G not sitting over there with a bunch of paint. You see, he don't have an apron on or nothing. He's just ready to do this. He's fun to talk to. He answers all questions. This is my guy. This is our third year with Mr. Gary G in the chat. Y'all already know what to do to start off our Tuesday and kick it off right. And then Gary in the chat, we just press all the buttons. That's standing ovation right there in the chat. They showing you so much love in the chat right now. And y'all give it up for Mr. Gary G. Yeah.
Hey, Cardi B. How y'all doing today?
Hey.
Y'all hear me?
We hear you fine, my guy.
I will. Okay. So, my name is Gary G. I've been drawing since I was like maybe 4 or 5 years old. I would just draw on everything in the house. Like, we used to get paper sacks back in the day and envelopes. And then one day when I was in like the sixth grade, my mom decided to give me an art kit and just have me start drawing for real. And, I kind of draw just about every day. And I think today we're going to do like the last few years, we'll probably draw some faces. So I'll show y'all how I lay out faces and we'll draw some faces. And we can twist them up to like Mr. Griff got the caricatures in the background.
Yeah. So
the same ways and we can just exaggerate the stuff. And we just going to start real simple, right? Now, mine, I'm going to make it a little heavy, but I want y'all to draw as light as you can. Because see, if you draw light, you'll be able to come over stuff and you won't be saying, I messed up and I got a race real heavy. So I'm just drawing heavier so y'all can see what I'm doing. Okay.
Mr. G, what do you say to a kid who's like, man, I ain't never gonna be able to draw good? I always mess up my lines.
If you can write your name, you can draw. That's it. You don't have to be perfect. You just got to start somewhere. That's all we're going to do is start. So we got a line. See, my line ain't perfect. Look, my line crooked at the bottom right there. It don't even matter. But you just want to get close as you can. So we got this line. That's our horizontal line. And we're going to put us a vertical line. What my fault? That's the vertical.
Exactly.
That's going to get me kicked out of kindergarten.
You so, the little kids, this is how you remember the difference between horizontal and vertical. The horizon goes that way.
Yeah.
Ta-da.
Okay. So then we're going to take another horizontal line. We're going to come halfway between this one and about our bottom line. Put us another little short line there. And then we'll come, let me see, halfway from here. Halfway. The camera's going, yeah. Halfway from here to here. Put a line right there.
Got my lines.
And I'm gonna put a line in the middle of that. Make a pen. Right over there. And I got three little lines there. Three little horizontal lines. I'm gonna put one more horizontal line in between this top two lines here. Now we got five lines. Six horizontal lines and one vertical line, right?
Somebody in my house.
No.
Sorry, Mr. Gary. Mr. Griff's wife just came home, just scared the bejesus out.
Griff home, pay attention. What's that rule? Pay attention.
Pay attention.
Pay attention. Okay.
Now, I mean, Mr. Gary. Is the second line, is it as long as the first one?
Which line? This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, it can be. It can be about as long. We're going to change all the lines anyway. That's why I said draw a line. Okay. It's just our guidelines. Give us our guide. You can roll from there. So this first little short line here, we're going to go to the surface. Gonna put us a nice ring on the surface here. It's a circle, kind of like in the middle of it. You know, you go to the circle, or into the surface, you know, they got three big rings, right? But they got two big rings, two little rings on the side. So then we just put the little rings on the side here. Now we're gonna just say, we need a big top. The circuit's got to have a big top, right?
So yes.
Fine here. I'm just going to draw us a little triangle down right to the size of the big top, you know, the big semicircle.
Oh, I see the face.
Yeah. I see if your lines are off like mine, don't worry about it. Well, I see we don't have to be perfect, right? You just move it up. So for me, I'm going to start this one up a little bit. I'm gonna put a little V shape kind of over my line here. But my goal is to bring it to where my lines kind of meet, so I can just move my line up. So I'll just move my center line up, right? So if I just cheat and move my center line up, I got a V in the middle there, a V here, and this bottom line, we're gonna kind of make it like a bowl, a little bowl of ice cream or something. Y'all see that? So it's not perfect. Don't have to be perfect. It's just our
guide.
We're gonna fix all this stuff, right? So now we're gonna come up here, and there's a trick to eyes. And if you look on your face, right, you look at the eye, right in the center is about the same as your other eyes. It's the same distance on the eyes, right? So I like to kind of look here, say, so that's about like an eye. And I'll start this little eye. It'd be like a little football shape, or a little island, or a little circle, whatever. And just kind of put it in between your guidelines. And here's another one. Like, you can go to the museums, you can see the professional people like Picasso, Van Gogh, and Rembrandt, and their eyes would never look the same. So don't be hard on yourself. Be like, this eye is bigger than this one, and this eye is little, because it's how it happens in the museum a lot of times. So now this is where we start playing this game here. So we You're just going to put your name in parentheses right there. That's faking our circle. And we're going to put a little circle in here. Now we got two, right? We're going to put one more tinier circle in there. So it's kind of like a basketball, a baseball, and a pool ball, or a tennis ball or something, right? But nobody walks around with their eyes like that, right? So we don't.
Yes. Yeah, they do, but we just can't call them.
We don't want that big. So look, we're going to fix them crazy eyes. We just take a line right across the sides here. We start to shake them with the fingers. Okay, so now we got these little guidelines, right? So I can say that's a chin if I want to, or I can move that down a little bit. So I want to kind of make this little shape towards the face here. Just rolling up. So kind of like a little triangle from here to here in a sense. So if you look at your eyes, right, and you got this big old socket here, looks like a big old circle, and then your jaw start to form like right under your eyes. So it's kind of like brown here, about the size of your nose, where your jawbone starts. So we can give ourselves those little cheeks. So it's kind of from the side of your eyes. Right about your nose. Start giving yourself some cheeks.
My cheeks is messed up.
Mine messed up too, right here.
Okay.
I'm looking kind of crooked on the picture. But remember, this nothing has to be perfect yet, right? We kind of go out here a little bit. See, the whole goal is to try to keep it centered, and I didn't keep it centered. I just started, and I can have everything clean and then. But it's okay. It's just practice. We're going to get it together. We'll turn this crazy looking alien person into something. We can do it. I think we can do it. We've done it before. We can do it. We're going to do it.
Y'all got to love Mr. Gary G the way he just has fun. It makes it fun for us.
Let's work it out. So you see, we're going to work it out. So the nose here, we're going to put these little heels. And we're going to put in between them circles. See, now I got a bottom of a nose there. Then you got the little outside circles. Just come all around and up. Then just your guidelines. You just make your adjustments while we're going here. You say, that's a little off. So you're going to move it over, move it out, whichever way you need to move it. Ain't nobody erasing, Griff. Don't cheat. Go on mute. Unmute yourself. Our radio host gonna be on mute. You still on mute, Griff? Okay, so we got that nose right. So let's see, we got this triangle here, but we're not gonna get right on the triangle, okay? Yeah, I don't have an eraser even start. I don't even mute the eraser. We just gonna go over it. That's why I said go light. We just gonna go light with it. We'll fix it like that, right? So right here, we got that little triangle shape. Come out to the middle of that triangle. Make this little arch up here over your eyes.
You're doing a good job, Mr. Gary.
Thank you, Mr. Griffin.
You know, I'm just watching. Ms. Mariah, you got to jump in with him. Hold on. Let me show you what I got so far.
Oh, you rolling the wins?
I made my own forehead.
I'm trying to there. I don't know if y'all can see it.
Pull it back a little bit. There you go.
There you go. I like your nose, Ms. Mariah. I like that nose.
So look, now I'm gonna show y'all two ways here, right? So we got eyebrows. So say if you want to make a nice lady eyebrow like Ms. Mariah's, we can come right here on the outside. And we come in with it, And you want to shape it a little bit so we can get the more safety. You can reshape it, right? Then you color it in, boom, you got us eyebrows. Miss Brian got nice cuts on the ENC, so then we can arch it a little bit better. Then you might be like me and Griffin, you got them thick eyebrows, right? You got the thick eyebrows, check it out. Just come straight across and go over the top. Now we can make us a thick eyebrow. You want it bushier? Ours ain't that bushy, Griffin. I'm just trying to show them because you know some of them you having a bushy caterpillar on your eyes. So now we got a thick one, so we can go thin or thick. And some of you may be even better at shaving eyebrows than I am. So, you know, okay. So then I'm going to come back right. I still don't like this. That's my problem right here. See, my eye looks like it got hit in the eye. They got hit in the eye on this side. So I'm going to move my cheekbone down just a little bit there. And then I'll reshape that. I don't want that forehead like perfect, but I do want to shave. That was an excellent for an 80s box of grief. That would be a good one. And we can do the same with the chin. We can shape our chin. We'll just be going over stuff refined in that part. So let me see. Ears. We need some ears, right? So we can listen because we can't listen without ears. So right here, I'm going to look. If you look at your ears, you take my hat off. So your ears come like right about where your eyebrows at, the top of your ears, and the bottom of your ear come right about to either your right under your nose or right at your nose. So I like to cheat, and I do like these little marks here. I put a little hash mark right there, right on the sides, and then I just draw my line down. But then, you know, be like, well, I don't like that ear, Mr. Gary, and we just shape the ear, we just shape the ears too.
So you kind of got a little curve to the ear.
Put a little curve to it, or you can get Mr. Spock's if you want to, and you can point them up. Be like, I want elf ears today. You may get an elf ear, you know. That looks like a scroll ear. Anybody watch Scrolls, Secret Invasion? I'm just going to try to come in. Samuel Jackson is my favorite actor.
Yeah.
So that's why I act like that sometimes. I wouldn't say that ear, because I don't like that ear either, right? So we got a head just floating on a stick, right? We need a neck. So we're going to play this game here, too. So we'll say this side is the lady side, right? So when ladies' necks kind of curve in some, right? They curve in more than guys' necks. Like, see, mine is going straight down behind my ear. So for a guy, you can just go straight down. Stiff neck. And for a lady, just put a little curve in there. Come around that cheek with the little curve behind that ear.
Like the curve.
Yeah, the curve looks better than the anatomy. It is what it is.
It's amazing what a curve can do.
And just put your collar on. We got a collar here. I know this is crazy looking person, right? You don't fix my crazy looking person. Two face here. Let's fix the lips, okay? So we want to make the lips nice, soft. Ladies, I will give them more, like Ms. Mariah says, the curves. You got more curves on that side, right? And this side, not the dudes don't have curved lips, but they just give you not as curved as ladies do. We've got one side, a little more flat. You see the bottom here, the shape on the bottom like that. But then see, like Miss Mariah, I'm gonna use Miss Mariah because she's on the screen. So she has curved lips and it's a little more curved at the bottom too.
No, my lips on here looking real interesting.
Just so I can demonstrate. So, okay, so let me see. Let's fix our eyes. We want to fix our eyes, right? So see, like, Miss Mariah's got the nice lashes there. So look, let's get the side curve our eye down a little bit. You can play with your lashes like that, or you can just make them thicker, just give yourself thicker marks. It's nice. Then we can shape our eyes so we got the shape right, the ball shape. But all we gotta do is shape it however we wanna shape it. Let's move the details inside. How we doing out there? How's everybody doing?
Yes, tell us how you're coming. Drop it in the chat. Let us know if you're doing okay.
You can make it a little thicker, no problem there. So there's one eye, right? Mm-hmm. And he said, well, we don't want this eye to look like that eye. I'll just change the shape just a little bit. Might make it lean or heavier, so I'll add it heavier. That all we're gonna fix our nose, right? We just got our nose floating.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit. Put a little line there. Or if you wanted a heavier nose, make it look a little heavier. Make the guy side here. And we start looking at stuff like shade a little bit, right? I use my fingers a lot, but you can use a piece of paper too. If you're using pencil, if you're using pen, it won't work like that. Or a marker, it won't work. But there's still ways to make yourself look like you got shading and that other stuff too. Let's say if you're using a pen or something, you can shade like. This is called cross hatching. And you just put the lines together. And the closer you put the lines, it's like the darker your shadows will get. And the lighter, the longer you put your lines, it's like the lighter your shadows. It's just lines crossing over each other.
Tell us what your favorite part is, guys. Let us know in the chat. How you coming?
If I have to fix the face, crazy looking, right? What's missing? We're missing something, ain't we? What are we missing?
Hmm.
Oh, we need hair. Hair. Let's give ourselves some hair. So we can shape our foreheads. So you can draw a little line around and get yourself a hairline, however you want. I know it's tricky because we're doing two faces at once, right? The lips, what do you want to do with the lips? Your favorite is the lips. Oh, and the star wants a beard. Okay, so look, we get this guy a beard like Griff. You just make it fluffy, right? I'm only going to do half of it because we don't want to give our lady a beard. It's all a beard.
Mm.
So we'll do Griff. So we got to leave white, no color in. No color in, just make it bushy. That around here too. So now we got a little beard jumping out. Maybe we'll give Griff a little color. Got salt and pepper. They call it, you know. Now we old school. One day you'll be old
school.
So there's there. Okay. Let's do some hairstyles here. So let's say. You just kind of make a shape, whatever you want. I'm going to do some of Miss Mariah's braids here. See, I got to just shape the braids. I'm just making lines like spaghetti or whatever. And there's a couple ways you can do it, right? So you can just color them or fill them in and make lines like that, right? Or you can say, well, I don't like that, Mr. Gary. Give them some shapes. Crisscross them over. Fill it down here, right? And he said, well, I don't like the hairstyle, but Gary, you look for one something else. But we don't want to be bald headed here. We say, okay, give myself a hairline here. Say, okay, with the catch with the fade, and I just want to color this in, right? And I'll just start up here and we'll color the hair here.
Mm-hmm. So
maybe I don't want that haircut. I want a box. So you just bring the box up on the head. Mr. Griffin started that. See, got a little afro. So then we can say, there's the box shape. Turn the box shape, or we can turn it to an afro. Let me see. Let me change pages. We'll do this the right way.
I'm doing a lot of art courses. So it's going to be great, Mia. Chloe.
What hairstyles do y'all want to see? More braids?
Try. Drop it in the chat.
Okay, see AJ. AJ's getting down over here.
Dennis thinks they locked.
A little something. Who said they said locks? Cornrows, locks and braids. Let's get locks and braids. My thing, lock them. Here we go. We get it together. Sometimes the drawing boards get tricky. Clips are older. Okay, well, that's good. We're gonna do the quick routes here. These are heads. So these are my heads. So we got locks. What kind of locks do we want? Stick it up or we're hanging down.
What are we feeling, guys? Maybe a lock ponytail. That's Genesis the boat.
There's a few ways you can do locks, depending on how big you want. These are like the Florida locks. So really, whatever you do, you just want shapes. So we say we got locks that way. You make your locks this way. It's making the shapes, and then you got to style it right. And we see what we had. We know we need to line down the center, right?
Okay.
Now, one row hanging. We have another one. Well, we have dreads. That would be kind of the same as locks, but it just depends on how you want them to look. If you're not in dreads, just give yourself a little friction there.
I love it, Mr. Gary.
We got
Morris.
Who else we got? Did all of them?
We
got something else?
Anybody
want to
see a fro? Or
straight here. So fro. I love fros. I started this in the 70s, so I was drawing afros. Fine. And if you were really old in the 70s, see, I got those super fly undercover brother. They had the big old sideburns on the afros like that. Then they would have them sunglasses, they'd be like this.
Yes. Do we want to see some curls? Any curls?
Well, curls, I was giving curls. That was the 80s, right? He changed to a curl.
Love it.
Ready?
Star said, do ball.
What's one star?
I said, do someone bald.
Bald.
That's simple.
Just keep the hair out. It's bald. Something else, give a bald. It looks like Andy Warhol. Crazy here. How's it going over there, AJ?
Going good. I'm trying to finish up this hair, you know.
Really?
Oh, AJ got the real curly come on. Put the second Ryan.
So let's get some show and tell, AJ.
Uh-oh, come on, AJ.
See what you got going on.
Since I see AJ.
AJ, wow, this is awesome.
Working on
it. Drop it in the chat. How's Mr. AJ's picture looking? Natural born.
Straight hand on here. Straight on down with it. Let me get rid of a part there. Up run through the ear. Here, cover it over here. They said, good job, AJ.
Thank you.
AJ said, thank y'all. What else we got going on? What is this? Yeah. Oh, buttons? Gotcha. Get a bug going out here. Then I'm gonna go to Apple Bucks after they get this one. I like
Afro Puffs, we love it.
So she said a boom line. Boom. That's one version, right? This is my favorite. Like I use a lot of girls like this. Because when we was little kids, my little sister used to rock their Afro Puffs all the time. So I love Afro Puffs. I draw a lot of little girls with Afro Puffs in the pictures.
Let's see.
Uh-oh.
Hey.
Give her some little earrings, get some little loops, get her a little bun.
Now, guys, remember, if there are any questions you might have for Mr. Gary, you can drop it in the chat, and we will leave some time at the end, okay? Any questions, drop them in there.
Miss Mariah, look at mine.
Short, curly hair.
Okay. It's different, Mr. Griffiths.
You see the earrings? Hey, Mr. Gary, I gave mine earrings.
I see. We got some big old earrings over there. You got some money.
And that mustache.
I'm trying to tell you.
Look, he probably needs some eyelashes. He looked like all women before they, okay, never mind. All women don't have eyelashes. If you want to have a fetus face, you're welcome to one too. I like to fight the power one right there, Mr. G.
So
look, when you, I see you do the hair, first and then you fill in the eyes later.
Sometimes we're just doing hairstyles, but if you got them shapes, you can do whatever. So you can give it the shape, just say you got a face shape.
Yeah.
And you put the hair on it.
Oh, I like that one. I like that one.
They don't know. We just use little lines for the face, dot for the eyes.
Oh yeah, I got that one. That's my one right there, Miss. Ooh.
Yes, you can.
Look, I got that one quick. I picked that one up quick.
Oh, yeah, see, you got that quick.
I picked puffy that one up hair. Quick. Mixed curly hair.
Puffy hair. Okay, let's see how puffy is puffy.
From Genesis. That's what I was. See, Genesis, I was going for puffy hair, but I think my guy is mixed race, so he can't really get a natural like he want to. Let's see yours, Miss Mariah. You over there being nice and secretive.
You know, mine is, you know, she going through some things. But
Wait a minute, what's she going through? I want to know. She ain't got grocery money. Let me see her. Let me see her, Miss Mariah. Wait a minute, we want
hard times, okay? So just keep her in prayer.
Please let me see her, Miss Mariah.
Just keep her in prayer.
I like her. She look like she gonna come out of it on the other side, though. That's hey. Wait a minute, I got a tambourine somewhere. This is for your lady. Just let her know God is good. Hey.
One more.
I like that puffy one right there, but I don't think I'll ever get past Miss Mariah saying her piece is going through something. Please. You got to post that, Ms. Mariah. I'm posting mine. You got to post yours.
Ooh, let me pray about
it. And we gonna call yours struggle art.
Struggle art. My butt God, okay?
Butt God, yes. Won't he do it? That's the name of yours. The won't he do it face.
Old school Mohawk, like Mr. T and the Punk Rockers, and then we got New Jack 2000 or something.
I like the one. I like the locks right above the new jack. Locks. Yeah, that one. Yeah, I like that one a lot. I like how they look separate.
We did on them. So these locks, what we did is we just
got it.
A pattern and just put it in because you know people got locks half the time. They just different. Y'all replacing it.
Right. The Jay-Z ones are special. That's them. What's his name? Basquiat. The Basquiat lock. I like your guy with the glasses too. I'm gonna draw him.
Jay-Z, let me see them. Jay-Z Basquiats.
You know what's funny is I've been drawing the same. Once you get the nose, I think for me, once I got the nose and the ears, once you get the ears and where they go next to the eyes, then you can start drawing the face. You could draw a fat face. You could draw a triangle, right?
All you got to do is have it center. If you got this, if you got the eyes and the nose, you can go anyway with that.
Look at my dude with the glasses. I got him too.
Okay.
Look at Miss Mariah. Miss Mariah. I can't wait to see the kids because it's not about perfection. It's just about learning, having fun. And then here go the best part. I don't know. Here, I'm gonna ask everybody in the chat. Do y'all remember how old Mr. Gary was when he first started drawing? Let me see who know that. How old was Mr. Gary when he first started drawing? Let's see. 5. That's right. And then remember, he said he wasn't even until the 6th grade when he really was like, y'all, I don't think y'all was really listening. What was he? There you go. His mom bought him a kit when he was 12. they are listening. I take it back. No,
they said 4 or 5. I was drawing since I was 4 or 5.
Yep.
And they was probably 6th grade.
And then what was he, before he got an art kit from his mom, what was he drawing on? Let me see if y'all really remember. He was drawing on a bunch of stuff, he said, but it wasn't an art kit. What was he drawing on? The wall was
different. Oh, I got in trouble for the wall. Now my mom was okay with the wall. When I was your age, I got in trouble. That's one of them.
That's one of them. Envelopes and paper bags. There you go. Come on.
See, that's paying attention. That's why I like coming back to the Summer Art Institute at the Battle Walker. You know, not only got history and culture, I got kids that pay attention. They put in work. I like
it. I love it. You guys have done an amazing job. I can't make sure you go. And I know Ms. Mariah was telling you already, but make sure you go post everything online with your parents' permission, and put at Walker Theatre. Remember how to spell it? At Walker Theatre. Not theater, Theatre. Mm-hmm. At Walker Theatre. And we will, there it is right there. At Walker, Theatre. Or you can email it to info@themadamwalkerlegacycenter.com. Either way, now let me tell y'all why it's important. Now, don't say, I ain't gonna post mine up. Mine is too ugly. There's no such thing as ugly. I was just at a museum the other day, and it was a lot of things that I thought was ugly, but it was 9 people standing next to him going, I'll pay $45,000 for that. I'll pay $65,000. I got $71,000. Like, so look at, here's what's crazy, Mr. Gary, tell him, just what you drew right there and with all the faces on it, if you sign it, one day it'll still be something.
Mm-hmm.
Look, he gonna sign it right now. Good.
Absolutely.
And it's something. It just became something. It just became something. That is all. I can't hear you, Mr. G. You must have. So you guys gotta post your things. I'm taking a picture of mine. I'm going to post it. I really like my guy's earrings. We can't wait to see Miss Mariah's hallelujah lady.
Mariah did a great job.
Thanks.
Mariah is a poet. She just did a great job.
And then look, Mariah, did you draw? I drew people around mine, so I got my main dude. Who you know, and then he got his little homies on his left and the right. He got
my homies.
he got the little homies with him. So
mine is on the way to an open mic. So
wait, so open mic. I don't know.
Genesis says she added locks and curly hair
together. That's a new style.
That is a new style.
Are they gonna be asking for it next summer?
We might want to give Miss Mariah's lady Miss Mariah, you started it. It's not like somebody, you came for yourself. I guess that's okay if you come for yourself. Hey kids, right now, We just want to thank Mr. Gary G. And y'all know how we thank him. Can we show him a round of applause? Can we give him a round of applause in the chat? Can we? There you go. There you go. There they go. And here's the best part about drawing. You can continue when we're done. Like, you can say, you know what? I'm going to do the same thing he said. I'm going to take these vertical lines. I'm going to make my four horizontal lines. And then you could just listen. You'll just get better and better and better and better. Look at Mr. Gary. Mr. Gary's sitting there drawing. He's not even looking at the paper how we looking at it. He actually got it. It's like reading to a class. Like, you're not even supposed to be able to draw like that. Shout out to the girl with the Afro puffs by your hands. I like her a lot.
I love
that. Yeah, can we give him a grade, class? Tamir is starting it off A+.
Tamir, appreciate
that. Oh, you getting all kind of, they giving you the emojis and everything.
This class, like,
can we
class
give him a grade? I'm giving him a A's.
I like this. Oh man,
I'm gonna give you a gang of A's.
Appreciate y'all. Mr. Grimm gave me an A. That's all.
No, I gave you a bunch of A's. That's a bunch of A's.
Fans, y'all, we need at least 7 games this year. We need to win 7 games. We need at least 7 more games. We need to win more games this year.
We need to win more games, Mr. G.
More games. I'm gonna come to Vegas and visit them. This will be over.
Me too. Mr. G, thank you. Here come all your grades. We appreciate you. Somebody said C+. Just joking. Shout out to the Madden Walker Legacy assistant. That's hilarious. C+. Just joking. I should have did that, but I feel like she stole my shine. She copied and pasted mine.
You can't be the funniest one all the time, Griffin.
You know what? No. That is the realest statement ever. You are absolute. And on that note, we will end today where, guess what? You can't be the best drawer all the time. Look at Mr. Griff. First of all, look at my man's eyes. My man look like he ain't playing no games.
I like Mr. Ryan's on the way to the spoken word event because he got a story behind
it. Right.
Got a story behind
it. Okay, she done got, I see she done made herself up. I see she done, what? What?
Hold it together, hear me.
Ladies and gentlemen, young kids, camp counselors, Mr. G, one more time for Mr. Gary.
Yes,
sir.
Thank you all for having me. I appreciate it.
You, sir, are always awesome. You're very consistent. Star is saying hi, Mr. Gary, to you. How can they reach out to you, sir? Maybe you got an Instagram that a child could follow?
I got an Instagram, and it's called Original Gary G. So it's O-R-G-I-N-I-A-L.
No, you spelled that original wrong already.
I did. Mariah put it up there for me. Spoken word artist helped you. I'm a girl from the spot. Now I got a D. Messed up. But I'm on Instagram a lot of times. I'm on TikTok now, too, with the same name.
You better TikTok.
Yeah, I don't dance like y'all dance, so... But I might, if enough of y'all say dance,
Mr.
G, y'all dance. It's one
thing. Well, I got you right here. Original.
Uh-oh. Now me and Griffin's friends, I'm going to be out TikTok. Tell them about that. Y'all come back to the 80s, Mr. G, one day.
Right, Cabbage Patch with us a couple times. Cabbage Patch with us.
He was there. Yeah.
Hit him with the WAP, Mr. G. Hit him with the WAP. Hey! Hey! Miss Mariah, it's Miss Mariah's birthday week.
Birthday dance is cancer season. Yeah.
We will see you guys tomorrow. Here goes some music for Miss Mariah's birthday. Thank you guys for coming. Make sure you post everything.
Yeah.
Nobody pray for me. It's been a day for me. Yeah.
Hey, I remember syrup sandwiches and gram allowances, but nothing on them with some counterfeits. But now I'm counting this Parmesan with my accountant.